Hi, today's topic of video is steps in strategic sourcing process. As we know, sourcing is part of overall procurement and procurement is part of supply chain management. But before discussing the strategic sourcing process, let's define the sourcing first and the strategic sourcing. What is sourcing? Sourcing is the process of finding and selecting the suppliers, getting the goods and services from them, and then use them in our business to run it. What does sourcing activities included? Is finding quality sources of goods and services, negotiating contract, establishing payment terms, marketing research, checking of quality, considering outsourcing for the goods, and establishing standard for the goods and services. So this was the definition and some of the activities which includes in the sourcing. So let's now discuss what is basically strategic sources. So strategic sources and approach to supply chain management that formalizes the way information is gathered and used so an organization can use it consolidated purchasing power to find the best possible values in the marketing place and align its purchasing strategy to business goal. So basically what we are doing in strategic sourcing, we are consolidating the purchasing power of the total organization, then to find out the possible, the best value of the goods and services in the marketplace, and then our total purchasing strategy should be aligned with our business goal. So strategic sourcing is an institutional procurement process that continuously improves and reevaluates the purchasing activities of a company. So let's discuss steps in the strategic sources one by one. The first one is the understanding of everything about the spend category as the first step in the strategic sourcing process. So this means defining the category and the commodity. So which commodity we are going to buy? What is the current quantity we are using? Its types, its sizes, who is the user, where they are located, what is the process, and what else, who are the parties are involving in this purchase. And data must be documented in a much detail as possible as change may be needed. So what we do, we find out everything about the product and the service what we are going to source. Then studying the cost of component, that basically what we do before going in the marketplace to find the goods, we do the costing of this product and then analyze the suppliers. So we do two things, first the costing of the good, then analyzing the suppliers. So what kind of cost we are looking, and then in market for the risk and opportunities. So what kind of cost we are looking for the raw material and other variables such as labor and the transport and other calculations done of the supplier's cost. So these what are the other costs are associated with the sourcing. So we, this is kind of our homework. Then deciding from where to buy, the next step is we have to make the decision. So from where we will buy to make minimizing our risk and the cost and developing the strategic sourcing strategy. So like we have discussed, what is the strategic sourcing strategy? It should be aligned with our organizational goals. In this step, using a cross-functional project team is a must. Cross-functional means we are engaging people from the other department other than the sourcing or procurement. The strategy will be depending on the real alternatives there are to be current suppliers, what are other, you know, what we have suppliers and what are the alternative we have, how competitive the suppliers marketplace is, and importantly, how open the user are to be new suppliers. So we are looking in the marketplace about the competitiveness of, about the alternatives, and of how much we are open to accept the new suppliers. Then number four is soliciting the bids by using a request for proposal process. So what it is? It includes product or services specification, delivery time, service requirements, pricing breakdown, cost analysis, legal and financial terms, and the conditions. Often the evaluation criteria are also stated. So these are the things we give into the request for the proposal, and we bid to get the a price according to our specification and other requirement from our suppliers. Then number four, starting negotiating process. So when we receive these bids, we will start negotiating after making short list of those suppliers which are very close to our requirement. So we start, why we do the negotiation? To for further clarification, we need more details. So a good strategic sourcing strategy is to conduct multiple rounds of negotiation to get to the short list. So then we make our list shorter than if we after asking the clarification questions and other details. The final selection is usually done by the team and the sign off as per the approval process. So then we sign off after the selection, we sign off this process. Then number six is implementing and integrating the strategic sourcing process. This is kind of communication plan. So how we will implement, how we will discuss that this sourcing contract, how we will be executing this. So this includes any improvement to specification or process, if there's any change in delivery or service requirement or pricing. So everything we decide in this when we integrate this strategic sourcing process. Last but not the least is the benchmarking and the tracking. The result, by monitoring the current status of the commodity or category, ensuring that full value is being achieved. So we benchmarking mean we set the standards like I told you, and then we track, and then we will figure out that do we achieve those benchmarks, do we achieve our goals, do we achieve our objectives, and by tracking. And then go back to the step one after reviewing the supply market again and restart the process in a constantly evolving market. So this was the a very brief discussion about the strategic sourcing process. So please, if you have any question, write down in the comment section and I will try to answer that. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you.